Charleston. And we started off, we did a little part D of our solo jab routine that carried us to the end of the routine. And it looked like this. We started with our left foot, we did our rock step cross, a rock step cross, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, kick step, a rock step cross, a rock step cross, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, kick step. And then we did that again, and then we do part A, and then we reach the end of the song. So maybe we'll do another, maybe I'll do a filming next week of the whole thing, so you guys have the whole thing, or maybe you should do the song. I don't know. You'll get a video of the whole thing. And then tonight we do Charleston Swing Out. So we started off with this footwork. We started with the simple footwork, which is quick, quick, slow, a quick, quick, slow, a quick, quick, slow, a quick, quick, slow. And we put that together with the leads going in front on three, this out and in feeling, where we're also just moving in a circle as we go out and in. And then we broke away. So we did 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, set. It's one like a normal swing out. We're going to release on the 5. Here we release a little bit on the 6. And we talked about how whenever we're stretching away to make sure that we're not like throwing our upper body into it or making it too herky-jerky there, but to think about moving our center into that away part and keeping it really round and circular so the momentum continues. Then we put in some kick steps. So those look like this. We've got rock step, kick step, rock step, kick step, rock step, kick step, rock step, rock step, kick. And that's a lot easier to do, especially when the music gets faster. And then we're going to kick away. That looks like this. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1, 3. Just on that first, replaces that rock step. Just as a variation. And we talked about how that variation isn't something you have to do with your partner. It can be something that you do independently. To end it, the easiest way to practice it is to go 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, and then come around back to physical position, back into Charleston, whatever else. The last thing, do you want to just talk about really quick the difference between a regular swing out and a Charleston swing out?
Oh yeah, so one of the questions from Follows was, how do I know if the lead is going to do a Charleston swing out or a regular swing out? And one of the big things is when Jillian comes in front of me for a regular swing out, we have this stretch and she maintains a stretch here on 3 where we're kind of away from each other. And if we're doing a Charleston swing out, 1 through 3, We're kind of on an in on 3 where she's going to let me out on
5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 5.
So that's a big indicator to me.
I think that's it.